Hello, this is Venus ASML, and I've got a nice little unboxing video for you today. So I have been given a product to help out with improving the quality of my little tingle videos, and that product is a Blue Snowball. It's a new microphone. I don't think it's the newest model, but audio quality quite often has an industry standard which can't be broken anyway. If anybody's wondering about the eye patch, it's nothing to worry about. A trapped optic nerve which is agonizing, but not of any serious consequence to my vision or anything like that. So yeah, just very, very painful. So now we're going to unbox this. This is what the box looks like. It's a very interesting looking one. I'm just hoping it works with my setup. I hope so. Anyway. So the fourth part just contains the manual. To be honest, I've already had a little look through that. It's a condenser microphone with a USB output. So I'm going to be doing the videos slightly differently. I may not be appearing in them, which frankly for me I prefer. In future ones I may appear sometimes, but a lot more rarely. I think it's more about the audio and part of Venus ASMR is actually to do with a lot of digital audio techniques and editing, so obviously I need something a bit better than a phone to record that on, and I'm trying to build up a small studio in my room just for that, as I said. Anyway, the first part just contains the manual. Go through that and it's interesting. So that's what this part contains. And this is the microphone itself in a lovely crinkly little bag. The device has three audio settings, all depending on the range of which you're recording at. So I'll be interested to try those out and see how they go. It's a very gorgeous aluminium. Kind of reminds me of some of the older Apple computers. I used to absolutely love them. I still got one of the big backed Macs. It's called an eMac. A special edition they made. It stopped working unfortunately, but I don't have the heart to throw that away. It's just way too beautiful. Plenty of cardboard in here. So let's see what else they've given me in this. This little extra box. So we have the obvious cable. It's one of those quite cool looking clear ones. You can see right through. All in all, it just looks like a printer cable to me, but... And the little charger that it comes with to stand the microphone. So what we're going to do, just before I end this video and start trying it out, I'm going to show it to you on the tripod. It definitely looks like something for Quidditch, if that makes sense. If there are any Harry Potter fans. It's the Quidditch microphone. That is very good looking, a little alien looking, but Still gorgeous nonetheless. One thing I noticed, it has a little LED on the front, so that doesn't look quite good for any live broadcast. And let's have a better look at the cable. So we're going to see if what it looks like plugged in. Yep, and it definitely does light up. I'm just going to open an audio program and check that that's all okay. And it's able to monitor that. I think the next thing to do to replace would definitely be the computer. So let's just check that it's all picked up. Not very used to recording audio for a computer, so be patient. So yes, it appears to be picking things up okay. So I'm going to try one of the other switches, see how the monitoring changes. So on setting one, it seems to be picking up rather a lot, maybe a little too much. Setting two seems to pick up very little at all, really. Setting three seems to pick up better than the others, but there will be a full review with all of these settings tried out to see what you enjoy anyway. Well, thank you so much for watching my unboxing, and I look forward to releasing a few new videos with the Blue Snowball. They may be few and far between until I've got the studio set up, but they will be here. Thank you for watching, and please feel free to like and subscribe. And if you haven't seen it yet, there is an ASMR tribute to Stephen Hawking on my channel as well. Thank you.